Hello children, welcome back to our mathematics class children. So today you are going to learn one interesting topic children, which is comparison of numbers. Fine. So this you will be doing every day in your life, like in your daily life. Okay, many times you will be comparing the things, right? See, suppose you will be writing assignment test. Okay, your mathematics teacher has conducted assignment test for you, right? Then next day she will be giving the marks for you. So what you people will be doing children, will be very eager to find out your friend's marks, okay, and then start comparing. Okay, so comparing whether your friend has got more marks than you or less marks than you, and everybody will be very eager to know who got highest marks in the class. Okay, these are things are what children, this is nothing but the comparison of numbers. Okay, so this marks in the sense may be 2-digit or hardly 3-digit number, right? Now that you have learnt about 5-digit and 6-digit numbers, let's see how you can compare large numbers children. So there are certain rules which you have to follow, which makes the comparison very easy. Okay, fine. So let us learn one by one rule children. The first and foremost rule in comparison of the numbers, the first thing you should know children, I think you have already learned the symbols for comparison, right? So if not, just let's recall what are the symbols. Okay, so see here. Yes children, what is this symbol? The symbol is greater than. Greater than. Symbol is called greater than. Next, what is this symbol? Smaller than or lesser than also we can call, or less than. Okay, then one more, equal to. Equal to. Okay, these three symbols we'll be using when we compare the numbers children. Okay, so let's start children. The first rule in comparison of the numbers is, first thing you have to do is count the number of digits in the given numbers children. See, for example, count the digits. Okay, count the digits. Let's take one example children. Taking two numbers here. First number is 4631, next 745, right children? So I have two numbers I have taken, I want to compare them. First let me count the number of digits in the first number. How many digits are there here? 1, 2, 3 and 4. 4 digits are there here children. Here how many digits I have? 1, 2 and 3. 3 digits I have. Okay, what is the rule here? The more the number of digits, the bigger the number is. Okay, the number having more number of digits will be the bigger number. So according to that rule, which is bigger here? Obviously the first number is bigger because it has got 4 digits. Okay, so this is the bigger number. First number is greater than second number. So which symbol I have to put now? Greater than. So first number is greater than second number. This is first rule children. Count the number of digits in the given numbers. Next, second rule. Suppose I have same number of digits in the both the numbers. Equal number of digits are there. For example, when you have equal number of digits, equal number of digits, okay children. So see here I have 4 digits in this first number and 4 digits in the second number. Now I have to compare, should I put equal to here because equal digits are there? No children. What I have to do? I should start comparing the from the leftmost side, or else I can start comparing. I should say that I start comparing from the highest place. Which is the highest place here? This place. What is this place? 1000. bird. Okay, children, compare. Whatever digits are there in those places, you compare. What is the digit here? 4. What is the digit here? 7. Which one is bigger? 7 is bigger. Okay, 7 is bigger. So it means second number is bigger here. Or first number is smaller. So what symbol I should put now? First number is smaller than the second number. Or lesser than the second number. Which symbol I have to put now? First number is less than second. Suppose now I have equal digits and then equal same digit in the first place. Third example, children. Third example. I have first number like this. Second number also like this. Okay? So first and second numbers now. Now, as I said, because I have equal digits, I should compare first digit with the first digit of second number. So, when I compare, I found that the first digit of first number and the first digit of second number, that is thousands place digit, are same. So, if they are same, next, I should start comparing the next place, which is hundreds place. What is the digit here in hundreds place? 6. Next, for second number, what is the digit in hundreds place? 4. Compare these two digits. 6 is bigger than 4. It means first number is bigger than second number. Or first number is greater than second number. Okay. So, this crosses you have to continue, children. Suppose I have second place, that is hundreds place also equal. Then I should compare tens place. If tens place is equal, compare ones place digit. Okay. This process has to continue till you get the answer. Suppose if all the digits of first number are equal to all the digits of second number, it means that both the numbers are equal. That is, so if I compare 4 and 4, second place, hundreds place 6, 6, third, tens place 3 and 3, fourth, ones place 1 and 1, all the digits of first number are equal to all the digits of second number, then first number is equal to second. Equal to sign I have to put, children. This is how you compare the two numbers, children. Okay? Did you understand? First count the number of digits. First rule. Second rule, start comparing from the leftmost digit of both the numbers or highest place of the both the numbers. And continue like that comparison till you get the answer. Okay, children? So, I hope you understood how to compare the two numbers. Yes, children. So, I hope you understood how to compare the numbers, right? So, based on that, we can start exercise 1.3. First bit, children, comparison of the numbers. See here, compare each pair of numbers and put the symbols. What is this symbol, children? Just now we discussed greater than or lesser than in the box, okay? So, two numbers are given in the first question. What is the first rule I told, children? Count the number of digits. See, let us apply the first rule here. See, how many digits are there here? 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. And how many digits are there here? 1, 2, 3, 4. So, which one is bigger here? First one is bigger. Second one is smaller. So, always when I am putting the symbol, children, you should see the first number and put the symbol, children. Okay, first number is what? First number is greater than second or first number is lesser than second. What is that? According to the first number, you put the symbol, children. See here, first number is greater than second number. So, greater than symbol, you put here. Did you understand? Now, let us see the second one, children. Second one, here if I count the number of digits, I am getting 5 digits here. Second number also 5 digits. So, now both the numbers have equal number of digits. Then, what did we discuss then? When they have equal number of digits, start comparing from the leftmost place. Okay. So, the leftmost place here is 10,000. Okay. If you compare here, this is 1 here. The digit in that place is 1. Now, in the second number also, same place, the digit is 1. Both are equal. Next, start comparing thousands place. 0. I have 0 here. And the thousands place of second number, I have 7 here. Now, 0 and 7.
0 is smaller than 7. So, the first number is smaller than second number. So, what is the smaller than symbol? This one. First number is smaller than second one, children. Okay? So, okay, children. So, I hope you understood the first bit. Comparison of the numbers, two numbers. You can complete the remaining sums, children. Now, another bit in comparison of numbers is writing the numbers or arranging the numbers in ascending order, arranging the numbers in descending order. First, let us see ascending order. What do you mean by ascending order, children? Nothing but the ordering of the numbers in from smallest to biggest, or arranging the numbers from small to big, children. So, that is called as ascending order. Then, what is descending order? Descending order is nothing but arranging the numbers from biggest to smallest. So, in arranging like that, what we are doing in the process, we are comparing the given numbers here. We are comparing the given numbers. In the first bit, you have seen how to compare two numbers. But in these two bits, four numbers are given. But the procedure is same, children. Procedure is same. First, count the number of digits. Let us see first ascending order. See, four numbers are given. First, compare and count. First, count the number of digits, children. See here. How many digits are there? First number. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 digits are there. Second number. 4 digits are there. Third number. 4 digits are there. Fourth number. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 digits are there, children. And I told you already, the more the number of digits, the bigger the number is. Now, ascending order means small to big, I said. I want to write smaller number first. So, now, this is the bigger number here. Okay? So, here, these two can be the smallest. Okay? So, in these two, because I have equal number of digits, I compare again these two numbers, children. Okay? So, how do I compare when you have equal number of digits? Compare from the leftmost side. Okay, so 6, first digit from the left side, 6 here. First digit from the left side, in the, this number also 6. So both are equal. Next, start comparing the next place, 100th place, with 100th place here. Again, both of them are equal, 1 and 1. Next, compare the third place, 10th place, children, here. And with the 10th place of this number, here I have 9, here I have 0. Now, which is smaller among 9 and 0? 0 is smaller. So, which becomes the smallest number here? This becomes my smallest number. Okay. So, next smallest would be obviously this only. Because it will have only 4 digits. Okay. So, let us start writing the answer. Small to big, I have to arrange the given numbers. I found the smallest number. 6,109. This is my first number. Next smallest, 6,197. Now that I have completed these two, I just strike off with the pencil like this so that I will not get confused. Next, see the next two numbers. Obviously, here 6 digits and here 5 digits. This one is smaller. So, third number would be 61,901. Last and the biggest number, 2,16,179. What did we do? We arranged the numbers in ascending order from small to big. Then coming to the descending order, just the opposite we have to do. That is the same way we will find, children, the same role we play here also, but arrange them from big to small. Okay, it means I have to find which is the biggest number. Again, count the number of digits here also. So see here. Here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Here, 4 digits. 1, 2, 3, 4. And here, again, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So, here, first and last numbers are equal. Number of digits, second and third numbers are equal. But, 5 digit numbers are bigger. So, these two numbers I have to compare. Okay, start comparing from the leftmost side. 4, first place, 4. And here, 4, equal. Then compare the second place, 2 here, the second place, 7 here, which is bigger, 7 is bigger. So, this is the biggest number children. Okay, so let's write first these two, because these two are bigger numbers among the given numbers, and this becomes the biggest number. Okay, so 47,315. So this is done. Next, this is the next biggest, 42,474. Okay, so this two is completed. Next, because these two have equal number of digits, I should compare these two to find out which is next bigger. So here, start comparing. First place 1. Here first place 3. Which is bigger? This is bigger. So my next biggest number is 3,437. So obviously the last one will be this, 1,744. So this is how you have to do descending order. Arrange the numbers from biggest to smallest. So I hope you understood ascending and descending orders also. So you can solve the remaining sums of these two bits also, children, so that you can complete exercise 1.3. Thank you.